Hi, it's Darren from Martin Deerline. Today I'm going to talk about some feeder house adjustments on our combines. Basically, your feeder house is a pretty important thing, of course. It feeds the material to the rotor. So, of course, there's some important adjustments. We're going to start out in the front here with our feeder house drum. Our feeder house drum actually floats up and down as you bring material in it. There is an adjustment on it here, which is what we call the adjustment for feeder house drum height. And what it is if you adjust that into what we call corn position, you don't let the drum go all the way down. So what happens is the drum stays off the floor about an inch or so. In corn, that's a kind of an important thing because it, instead of it niblettering the corn, it feeds the corn smoother into the machine. For all other crops, pretty much you leave it down in the down position. What that does is that lets that feeder house drum come down to the floor, the slats are close to the floor, and it cleans the floor off so material does not build up on the floor of the combine. It does float anyhow, so as you stuff more material to it, the drum lifts anyhow. So really, the lowered position is our position for small grains. That's the position that we're running that in, including canola. So that's your feeder house drum adjustment. How you would adjust that is, of course, on the newest machines, we now have to use a wrench. So you take a 24 millimeter wrench and you'd put it on here, pull the pin, and turn it up on both sides. On the older machines, we actually have a lever here that you can just pull the pin and lift it up and down. They had gone away from that just because for clutter and that in the feeder house, it's easier to put a wrench on there than it is to get at the lever. So that's your feeder house drum adjustment. Then next of all, of course, this is the back shaft that we drive the feeder house with. So it drives down from the other side through the reverser gearbox and comes out on here, which is what we call the back shaft. So then from the back shaft, it drives up this chain and goes up to our slip clutch. So there's different speed changes we can make on the machine. You can get a machine with what we call variable speed feeder house, but what we've found is for the expense of the variable speed feeder house, a couple of sprocket changes can do the same thing and work well for us. So the other thing about it is when you use a variable speed feeder house, you speed the back shaft up, so now you start running the header auger or drapers faster than just using the standard back shaft speed. So this machine here, we have the 26-32 tooth combination on here. And of course, we're driving from the bottom up. So of course, the bigger sprocket is the faster speed. The 32 tooth sprocket works very well in canola, wheat, most of your crops. As you're stuffing the machine, we put quite a bit into these feeder hoses, and running the feeder hose faster, we're finding it's working a lot better, also giving us better slip clutch performance. So the 26-32 tooth, basically it's just a matter of sliding it on the coupler here, you slide it back and forth. When you do that, there is also the adjustment here on your slots for your chain. What happens, of course, is if you go to the smaller chain, you lower this. And for the bigger chain, bigger sprocket, you raise this. When you go to the smaller sprocket, if you're looking at this right here, you'll notice the smaller sprocket will be it's to the inside here, but it would be at a smaller rate. So then this chain would be coming down. So if you left this in the high position with that chain coming down, you're gonna pull down on that chain and you're gonna have this whole assembly here is gonna really take a beating, and these things are all ripped off and everything. So make sure if you do go back down to the small sprocket that you do take these bolts out and move down to the lowered position on your chain drive. So again, we're driving from the bottom up to our slip clutch, which is up here. Slip clutch upgrades, our highest capacity slip clutch now is a 1500 newton meter in reverse, 1350 in forward slip clutch. It goes on right here, bolts on. It is greasable. These slip clutches do like grease. If you grease that slip clutch, what I like to tend is with a full slip clutch, you basically combine until you start having some feeder house slipping issues, and then at that point you grease this guy, give her about 5 or 6 shots, and away you go. The proper way to do that then is once you slip the slip clutch again, that's when you start thinking about greasing it. And again, that makes a big performance difference on your combine. So the 1500 Newton meter slip clutch is a really good upgrade if you don't have it on your machine. So that's the things about the Feederhouse performance.